amazing. What a record. Played with these guys years ago and met Colin Blundstone and Rod Argent, and it was just insane. Absolutely amazing album. Totally diverse musical influences. Some of the best keyboard parts ever. Greatest melodies, probably, you know, outside the Beatles, maybe, yeah.
I remember hearing this years ago and thinking his vocal delivery was incredible. Really good record. That kind of like Elliott Smith.
Yeah, working with him as a producer was it was 12 days of like pure creativity. No boundaries. He's responsible as much as we are for the sound of Exotico, and he really steered the ship into, you know, the best island it could be, really. Oh, Joe Meek. You see, this isn't his best work, but what an inspiring producer.
Yeah. I think it sounds like it's from a different planet, which is probably what he was going for.
I think he might have with the title.
Yeah. Groundbreaking. I know it shouldn't be
right, but I can't sleep at night. Best fuzz sound ever. People think of like Satisfaction when they think of fuzz guitar, but they really shouldn't. They should think of Treble by the Music Machine. If anyone out there knows what fuzz pedal this is, please send them to my address, at Buckingham Palace. This is punk before punk was punk, you know. Actually, on this album, we stole one of his techniques, which is to speed up and slow down certain instruments to make them sound not like the instruments they are. So he did this a lot with guitar, and her vocals are just amazing. And all of this stuff pretty much was recorded in hotel rooms with a remote recording setup. So some of the most complex but beautifully pretty music. Sounds nothing like what we do, but it's still heavily inspires parts of what we do. So.
Pete Kemba, met him once, I think. He came to our show in Birmingham.
He did, he was, yeah.
Yeah, and he had fantastic fringe suede shoes on. I think that's the one thing I can take from meeting him. Great record. Fairly local to where we're from.
Mm. Rugby. Yeah.
Rugby. Is that Warwickshire?
It's just down the A14 in England, if you know the A14.
Yeah, but anyway, Henry's favourite.
Yeah.
What a record. I think there was a period between 2014 and 15 where I used to listen to this record every night to go to sleep. Amazing ambient music, and as you can tell from the microphone in the picture, some serious field recordings.
I've hung around. Yeah, one of the greatest singers of all time. The album's faultless, but so is 1, 2, and 4. So, but that, what a cover as well! What an amazing cover, beautiful azure blue eye. It kind of looks like it could be a very feminine Bowie eye from the period where he was putting blue around his eye, but it definitely isn't.
I'll never forget the first time I saw Beat Club, which I think was a German TV program, and they play Shaking Eye King on it with all the green screen in the background. You know,
we used to put those videos on before gigs, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
It's not for us to say.
The best album you haven't heard yet.
Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully someone out there's favourite album of all time.